Whether you know him as Stiles Stilinski, Thomas the Maze Runner, or, well, himself, it's hard not to be a fan of Dylan O'Brien. But if by chance you haven't watched any of his stuff, then you've got a shot to catch him on Netflix in Love and Monsters. But first, let's take a look at his career so far on his road to Netflix. Before he got stuck into his first major roles, did you know O'Brien had a hilarious YouTube channel under the moniker MovieKid826? He started posting skits and music videos there way back in 2006.
Okay. That's backwards.
His early YouTuber days definitely got him noticed. In fact, those videos are what got him an agent, and that agent sent him on auditions.
Who cares? If you know... Sorry, that was way too loud. I'm sorry.
And one of those auditions was for a beloved part you may know very well.
Just focus on the cross for now, okay? That's all you gotta do, yeah?
Here we go.
The quick-witted and fiercely loyal Stiles Stilinski in MTV's Teen Wolf became O'Brien's breakout role, and one which he played for 6 years.
What are you?
For a little while I was possessed by an evil spirit. It was very evil.
What are you now?
Better?
Teen Wolf became one of MTV's most successful scripted shows and helped build O'Brien a massive fandom. The same year Teen Wolf premiered, O'Brien also made his movie debut in High Road, a completely improvised comedy film.
Don't believe in the triangle theory.
Because it doesn't make sense.
It does make sense.
No, okay, all right.
Are you listening?
Yeah, I got a triangle for you. It's you, a piece of dog shit, and then another piece of dog shit.
In 2012, he went on to star in teen romantic comedy The First Time, alongside Victoria Justice and Britt Robertson.
What?
It's just the cops are here.
He played a millennial glued to his phone in The Internship, a 2013 comedy film starring Vince Vaughn and Owen Wilson as two laid-off salesmen trying to get a job at Google.
I'm your Bill Holden as Dalek 17.
I really don't get that reference.
Google it.
Got it.
That year, he also appeared in web series First Dates with Toby Harris.
Because these chicks, I'm telling you, they're in the kitchen and they're DTF.
They're here?
Yes, they're in the kitchen.
What do we mean DTF?
She's down, you know? She's down. Go down, Toby, down.
And who could forget his cameo on sitcom New Girl's second season?
This man's dead.
What? Oh my God!
There's so much death in the world.
Seriously, dude, take your pills. I'm sick of you.
I'm sick of you.
Those big roles kept coming in, and he landed the lead role in young adult dystopian franchise, The Maze Runner. The first film came out in 2014, with O'Brien playing Thomas, a 16-year-old who finds himself trapped in a huge maze with no memories.
Somebody built the maze. I think it's time we find out what we're really up against.
This was a role he reprised in 2015's The Scorch Trials.
This is about everyone Wicked's ever taken. They'll never stop. So I'm gonna stop them.
In between filming the Maze Runner franchise, he also appeared alongside Mark Wahlberg in Deepwater Horizon, a disaster film based on the real-life explosion off the coast of Mexico in 2010. The same year Deepwater Horizon came out, O'Brien suffered serious injuries which almost derailed his career while filming a stunt in the final Maze Runner sequel, The Death Cure. In interviews, he said he had to undergo facial reconstruction surgery and required months of recovery, both physically and psychologically. He was eventually able to return to filming, and the film was released in 2018, including the take he was injured making, something O'Brien said he was grateful the director kept in.
How many kids do they have to round up, torture, kill? When the hell does it stop?
For 2017's action thriller American Assassin, he had to not only recover from that injury, but also get into peak physical shape to play CIA Black Ops recruit Mitch Rapp.
My guess is if you and I go hand to hand, you can probably figure out inside of 20 seconds whether or not I have what it takes to make it through selection process. So, what do you say?
In 2018, he took on an iconic role in the Transformers universe as the voice of Bumblebee.
Sorry, I'm late. Hit a little traffic.
That same year, he made a return to his YouTube channel in a satirical video about the life of an out-of-work actor, showcasing the same wit which got him noticed in the first place.
You know, people keep asking me to, my friends, my mom, Dylan,
when are you gonna go back to work? And my answer is the same thing every time. Why would I go back to work when I am the most productive I have ever been right now?
His brief return as a YouTuber preceded another bit of YouTube work in 2019 on a YouTube original series called Weird City. The sci-fi anthology was set in the near future, where society is split into two halves. O'Brien plays a character who was born in one side but now lives on another, and gets an unexpected matchup on a high-tech dating service.
Hi.
Hi, can I help you?
I'm Bert. I'm your one that's the one.
Hey. Don't come in.
With 2020 being what it was, many of O'Brien's films from that year are coming to a streaming service or a theatre near you this year. One of those is Flashback, previously titled The Education of Frederick Fitzell, a mystery thriller where O'Brien's character is obsessed with finding out how to solve the mystery of a missing girl from his old high school.
I think I've had some kind of flashback. It's just one night, we were all in work. Can't shake the feeling that something bad happened to her.
And then, of course, there's the film which brings O'Brien to Netflix.
Ready?
Mm-hmm. I love it.
That's super sweet, because it's terrible.
Love and Monsters is set in a world where monsters have taken over, and also torn two high school sweethearts apart.
Amy, I love you. I'm gonna come find you.
7 years after the monster apocalypse, they reconnect via radio, and Joel, played by O'Brien, decides it's time to reconnect against the odds, face to face.
How far away is Amy's colony?
85 miles. It's an impossible journey. Everything will try to kill you. Don't fight, just run and hide.
Okay.
And what are a few deadly encounters with monsters when true love is on the line? Lucky for you, Love and Monsters just dropped on Netflix, so you can't miss it. And for more on your favourite Netflix stars, make sure you subscribe to the channel.